Feeling down about the wild price swings in the crypto market? Don't. Now, all should feel right in the world. I'm Catherine Ross from Cointelegraph, and this is your weekly Hodler's Digest. Have you ever heard about this word, blockchain? I'm sure you did. At the height of the Bitcoin frenzy, blockchain became a buzzword, and companies tried to use it to boost their market value. Entertainment companies bragged about ties to blockchain, while tobacco businesses got into crypto mining. Every kind of business, it seems, now has tulip-grown facilities. Cut and pasting the term blockchain is cheap. The result is a brief uptick in the market value, and then a dip when the market realizes the company has added nothing of substance to their profile. Using buzzwords to benefit your stock price is nothing new. During the tech bubble, companies saw their value skyrocket, then crash after adding .com to their names. It became so common that companies actually rallied after dropping the suffix. In many ways, blockchain is like a young Matthew McConaughey, too sexy to be taken seriously. Older Matthew McConaughey is slightly less sexy, but he's taken more seriously as an actor. Think True Detective or Dallas Buyers Club. Okay, Interstellar sucked, but you get the point. Blockchain needs to be the older Matthew. People need to be bored with it because it works so well. It needs to become part of the everyday infrastructure, not a digital gold rush.
Blockchain is a revolution that won't be televised because immutable ledgers are McConaughey with his shirt on. Boring.
2018 has been a busy year for Schiller and Chief John McAfee. He announced the 2020 presidential run, his own fiat currency backed by crypto, and he revealed that he charges $105,000 per tweet to promote ICOs. Will you vote for McAfee in 2020? Meet Ladislav Mecir, a.k.a. Bitcoin Grandpa. A 57-year-old computer programmer from the Czech Republic is the single most prolific contributor to Bitcoin's Wikipedia page. He spends 2 hours a day editing and maintaining crypto articles on the site.
He's providing a valuable service. The Czech Republic loves Bitcoin. It is home to the first Bitcoin mining pool and Alza, aka the Czech Amazon, which accepts Bitcoin. Having lived through the Soviet Union, Ladislav is no stranger to misinformation and censorship. So it's important for him that people have access to good info. I don't want any censorship. I hate it, certainly. Mecir fights a daily battle with anti-Bitcoiners who vandalize the page and think crypto is a scam. He has even been accused of being Satoshi himself. Despite being deleted several times, Mecir has contributed over 1,000 edits to the article.
He has no regrets about not investing in Bitcoin at $2 back in 2012. He is risk-averse and just wants to pay off his mortgage. So guys, don't get down or out of the market. For every McAfee, there is a Ladislav. Like to go for a walk with Bitcoin Grandpa? Like, subscribe and hodl, and he'll get you some pie as well.
Cointelegraph. Like, subscribe and hodl.